Well?
Who are you?
My name is unpronounceable in your tongue.
Jill, it's the night before curtain opens.
Don't you call me,
how's it going?
It is indeed the night before curtain opens, and as always, you have last-minute things that crop up, ideas that you have that you would like to incorporate. It's going well, actually. Tonight, being the dress rehearsal, we get to set off some pyros and play with the dry ice. So that should be fun later on.
So what's the last-minute preparations tonight?
Last-minute preparations is making sure that the pyros and mainly the dry ice is set safely and people know how to operate them. And we get to see the costumes in their full glory for the first time in the stage setting. And just making sure that everybody knows what they're doing backstage, because there's a lot going on backstage that the audience don't get to see.
It is quite an elaborate show, isn't it? There's a lot going on.
It is. There'll be backdrops flying in and out, curtains opening and closing, lighting's going on and off in different areas of the stage. So there'll be a lot for the audience to take in at various parts in the show.
It's a gamble putting on a Pratchett, but there's always a good following for Pratchett stuff. Has the gamble paid off?
We hope so. The tickets have gone well within the company. I haven't actually spoken to the theatre's box office, but we have advertised widely, so I'm hoping that all those Pratchett fans out there will come and see our little production. The story, basically, Terry Pratchett has taken Shakespeare's Macbeth and set it in the Discworld. You have the three witches, and the play opens with them around the cauldron, as you would expect in Macbeth. And from there, it gives the Discworld twist that only Terry Pratchett can do, and gets out that humour from everyday situations, but placed in a different world to our own.
Jill, we wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much.
It is Wixit Hook Plaza.
Where were you when the bells rang it out? Behind the door?
Well, Mr. Wuxel-Juplazar, I expect you're wondering why we called you here tonight.
You're not supposed to say that. You're supposed to say...
Shut up! We have the Sword of Art and the Octogram of Protection.
I really advise you all to return home.
There's probably been a misunderstanding. Everyone knows a witch cannot be held against her will.
It's gone too far this time. All this burning and taxing. It's got to stop.
This one here.
I'm blaming you.
Let me see. Champox the Good. Was he? How do we know? Is he good now? All we know that at the end
died.
Of the...
And...
No, m'lady, it takes a special talent.
But can you find someone who has it?
There are such people in Ankh-Morpork, my lady. Perhaps.